UN Special Rapporteur on Extrajudicial Execution, Agnes Callimard, joins me now live from Park City in Utah. Thank you very much for joining us here on TRT World, Agnes. So what is it that you have seen that makes you claims of Crown Prince hacking Jeff Bezos' phone?
Well, the process followed by TRT, the company responsible for the forensic investigation, has been extremely thorough and robust, because they have done this investigation as part of an FBI investigation. So the process followed by that company has been very robust. We received the report a few months ago, and over the last few weeks, we have consulted our own independent expert who have reviewed the findings and the work of that initial forensic investigation. And they have concluded, following a range of expert exchanges, that the most likely source of the hacking of Mr. Bezos' phone was indeed a WhatsApp message originating from an account owned by the Crown Prince of Saudi Arabia. The evidence provided is, as you can imagine, very technical. One of the most probing element of it is the fact that immediately after receiving the video file from that WhatsApp account, the phone behaved in a very different fashion than it had done before receiving that message. And in particular, the data being exported out of the phone increased by thousands of percentage.
And have you been speaking to Jeff Bezos, or will you be speaking to Jeff Bezos in this investigation?
Look, I have not spoken with Jeff Bezos directly. What I can confirm is that following the UN protocol, following the work method of Special Rapporteur, we have received consent from Jeff Bezos to go forward with our claims and our public claims in particular. So, of course, we will not have gone public without the consent of the victim. And in that case, it was Jeff Bezos.
Okay. And what was the Crown Prince motive here? Why hack Jeff Bezos' phone?
Look, in my opinion, and in the opinion of my colleague David Kay, the hacking of Jeff Bezos appeared to be primarily motivated by the desire to control information, and particularly negative information. At the time Jeff Bezos' phone was hacked, Jamal Khashoggi was already writing for the Washington Post and had published very critical pieces. So that was May 2018. In addition to that, the phone of other Saudi dissident, such as Omar Benaziz, Yahya Asiri, or Ghanem al-Mansour, all of those had been hacked in very similar circumstances, and them too were related somehow to Jamal Khashoggi. It's also very possible that the phone of Jamal Khashoggi was hacked at that particular time, but we do not know that, because the phone is in the possession of the Turkish authorities, and they have not revealed any information regarding whether Jamal's phone had been hacked. So all of information.
Yes, Agnes, just the connection there with the murder of Saudi journalist Jamal Khashoggi, do you think there's a timeline to the events that makes this connection? What was the actual aim here?
Yes, I believe that there is a relationship between the hacking of Jeff Bezos and what eventually became the killing of Jamal Khashoggi. But I do not believe that at the time Jeff Bezos was hacked, the objective was to kill Jamal Khashoggi. I think the objective was to understand the information context within which Jamal Khashoggi and the Washington Post were operating. It was a way of keeping on top of the information context, and in a way maybe of beating up the negative information that was coming out of the Washington Post, but particularly out of Jamal Khashoggi. So the hacking is motivated by the control of information and the silencing of viewpoints that are perceived as being threatening. I will not suggest that the hacking was part of an attempt already to plan the killing of Jamal Khashoggi.
Okay, but you are saying it's not out of the picture.
The fundamental aspect of this allegation, yesterday's allegation, is that they place Mohammed bin Salman solely and centrally within the campaign against Jeff Bezos, of course, but more generally, the campaign to control information. And if you recall, during my investigation into the killing of Jamal Khashoggi, I stopped short of determining the nature of the responsibilities of the Crown Prince. I did say that there is sufficient evidence pointing to the fact that he held responsibilities, but I could not conclude whether or not he ordered the killing or whether he more simply, quotation mark, failed to prevent the killing. What the allegations show to us is that at a minimum, he created the conditions whereby the campaign against dissident, whereby the campaign against critical and negative information were being led and launched. So the allegation places him much closer to the killing of Jamal Khashoggi than at least I had been able to do until now. Of course, we do know that the CIA had leaked information suggesting that he was actually directly, that he had directly ordered the killings. This is not something I could determine on the basis of my work, but yesterday's allegation placed Mohammed bin Salman much closer to the context and to the campaign that eventually led to Jamal Khashoggi's killing.
And one last question, Agnes, there. So Jeff Bezos today tweeted breaking his silence with a photo. What did you make of it?
Look, I think, I was at this particular ceremony in Istanbul. I think Jeff Bezos, by tweeting the way he did, made it clear that in his opinion, the hacking into his phone had some direct implication into the killing of Jamal Khashoggi. And he certainly is linking the hacking with what happened 6 months later.
Well, as a journalist, I hope we find out the truth one day. Well, thank you very much, Agnes Callimard, for joining us here on TRT World and for that insight.
Thank you very much to you.